woman. Genesis 37 and 2. It reads as this. These are the generations of Jacob. Joseph, being 17 years old, was feeding the flock with his brethren. And the lad was with the sons of Bilhah and with the sons of Zilpah, his father's wives. And Joseph brought unto his father their evil report. Now Israel, he loved Joseph more than all his children, because he was the son of his old age. And he made him a coat of many colors. And when his brethren saw that their father loved him more than all his brethren, they hated him and could not speak peaceably unto him. And Joseph dreamed a dream, and he told it to his brethren, and they hated him yet the more. And he said unto them, hear, I pray ye, this dream which you have dreamed. For behold, we were binding sheaves in the field, and lo, my sheaf had rose and also stood upright. And behold, your sheaves stood round about and made obeisance to my sheaf. And his brethren said to him, shalt thou indeed reign over us? And shalt thou indeed have dominion over us? And they hated him yet the more for his dreams and for his words. And he dreamed yet another dream and told it to his brethren and said, behold, I have dreamed a dream more. And behold, the sun and the moon and the 11 stars made obeisance to me. And he told it to his father and to his brethren. And his father rebuked him and said unto him, what is this dream that thou hast dreamed? Shall I and thy mother and thy brethren indeed come to bow down ourselves to thee to the earth? And his brethren envied him, but his father observed the saying. I'm going to title this message in our How Excellent series, Keep the Dream Alive. Somebody touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, keep the dream alive. Yes, you got to keep the dream alive. You better know that there is something on the inside of you. There's something great that God wants you to do in the earth. There's something awesome and magnificent that he wants to perform through your life. And that is a dream. Amen? Amen. Amen. Here in this narrative, as I begin to unpack this story, we can see that Joseph, the son of Jacob or Israel, lived in the land of Canaan. The scripture says that he had 10 half-brethren. He had 10 half-brothers, one full brother and one half-sister. He was Rachel's firstborn and Israel's 11th son. Of all the sons, Joseph was loved by his father the most. Israel even arrayed Joseph with what they call a coat of many colors. Israel's favoritism toward Joseph caused his half-brothers to hate him. And when Joseph was 17 years old, he had two dreams that made his brothers plot to his demise. In the first dream, Joseph and his brothers gathered bundles of grain. Then all of the grain bundles that had been prepared by his brothers gathered around Joseph's bundle and bowed down to him. In the second dream, the sun, the moon, the 11 stars bowed down to Joseph himself. When he told these two dreams to his brother, they despised him for the implications that the family would be bowing down to Joseph, and they became jealous that their father would even ponder Joseph's words concerning the dream. As I look at this text, one of the first things that jump out at me as a believer is that Joseph, he was a dreamer. Somebody say, he was a dreamer. Joseph was a dreamer. It just simply means that he had a dream on the inside of him. He had something on the inside of him that God deposited on the inside of him. And I want to begin to talk about dreams, because many of you all have dreams. Many of y'all have gone to sleep at night and you have pictured yourself as being in another place. You have pictured yourself doing something great in the earth. So let me define what a dream is. A dream is nothing more than this: a succession of images, thoughts, or emotions passing through the mind during one's sleep. It is also an aspiration. It is also a goal. It is something that God places on the inside of you to where sometimes you can't even rest until you begin to walk out the dream that He have placed on the inside of you. Anybody been having some dreams lately? Some dreams for their family, some dreams for their church, some dreams for doing some things in the kingdom of God. Can I say that's nothing more than a goal? That's nothing more than an aspiration? Can I say for the year 2017, God wants to make sure that you have the wherewithal, that you have the confidence, the consistency to make sure that the dream that He placed on you will not die, but yet it will come alive. I wish I had somebody that understood that dreams, they do this. They reveal who you are and what you will do. I remember this because I had a dream that God wanted me to pastor one day. I had a dream that God wanted us to have a church. And the church was called Forward Christian Center. He gave me this dream when we didn't have the money to start Forward Christian Center. He gave us the dream when we did not have any people that would commit to carrying out the work of God for Forward Christian Center. But can I say, when God gives you a dream, when you begin to walk out the plan and the dream and the assignment that God has on your life, you might not know how He's going to do it, but if God said it, you better believe it's got to come to pass. And I just want to stir your spirit this morning because I want to let you know the dream only reveals who you are. It reveals who you are. It reveals what you will do. So many people have dreams. So many people have goals. So many people have aspirations. But they're scared to step out of their comfort zone to begin to walk in the plan and purpose that God has assigned for their life. Do I have any dreamers here this morning? If you're a dreamer, you know that God has deposited something great on the inside of you. Raise your hand. If you know that God has deposited something great on the inside of you, I remember when we started Forward Christian Center. We didn't have any money. We didn't have any people. All we had was the Word of God. And we began to step out on nothing and we began to find something there. Why? Because we began to walk out the dream that God had on the inside. I want to encourage somebody today to let you know, God forbid that you die with the dream that's on the inside of you. Many people have said one of the most richest places on the face of the earth is the cemetery. Why is it rich? Because there are a whole lot of people that died with corporations, million-dollar corporations, million-dollar businesses, all kind of things that should be spawned off in the earth. Instead of them stepping out on their dream, they end up going to the grave. So the grave was made rich because of their inability to step out on their dream. So that leads me to my first thought. Dreams, write it down, can be dangerous. Dreams, they can be dangerous. They can be dangerous. Anybody that have a dream on the inside, know that that is what makes you dangerous. People are upset because you have a dream. Your boss wants to keep you on your job forever. He don't want to see you keep your dream alive. He wants you to work for Him all the days of your life. But the devil is a liar. Yes, yes. I hear some of y'all that have that longing to see your dream come to pass. When you begin to step up one day and say, boss, you fired. Yeah. Y'all not saying that. Y'all too churchy this morning. Now, see, you have to have that dream kicking on the inside of you so much to where you're not intimidated by what you see that's happening in your life. The reason why dreams are dangerous is because dreams release you visually, mentally, and emotionally from your now. They release you visually, mentally, and emotionally from your now. Well, what am I saying? So many people get caught up and being stuck and not moving in the dream that God has on the inside of them because they're so concerned with the conditions on what they see or what they lack or what they don't have on the outside. But when you got a real dream on the inside, you'll begin to visualize, not when you're here, but you'll visualize yourself over there. You'll begin to mentally come from over here and take yourself over there to where you step outside of what you don't have and who you are. And it'll allow you to walk in everything that God says that you can have. Why? Because God will supply all your needs according to his riches and in glory. It's not based on what you have right now, but your dream is connected to what you will have in your future. Keep your dream alive. Who said you can't sing? Who said you can't minister? Who said you can't have your own corporation? God says, I have given you all things that pertain unto life and godliness. Somebody say, keep your dream
alive.
And the scripture says that Joseph was one of the favored sons. He had favor with his father. Why did he have favor with his father? I don't know. That's just one of the baffling things about favor. It is favor ain't what? Some of y'all have favor on your life. And when people come and ask you, how are you doing these things? How God is meeting your needs? All you can say is, I don't know. Why? Because favor ain't fair. Joseph had a father by the name of Jacob, and the scripture says that Jacob gave his son Joseph out of his other brothers a coat of many colors. That coat of many colors simply meant that Joseph's life was going to be an example, not just to his local community, but to the nation. It was a coat of many colors. That coat of many colors represents the different nationalities. It represents the Arabians. It represents the Chinese. It represents the Africans. It represents the European. So in other words, Jacob gave his son Joseph a coat that says, hey son, your life is going to exceed this city that you're connected to, and it's going to begin to speak to the nations. And because of that, his brothers, the scripture says, they began to envy Joseph. They begin to envy Joseph. Dreams can become dangerous because it will cause people that's assigned and attached to your life to begin to envy you.
Amen, amen.
There'll be some people in your family that don't want to see you come up. There'll be some people that's connected to you, that's your friends, and you think that they're your friends, and you think that they're your ride or die. You know, you roll with them coming up. But can I say, if God sometimes have a plan for your life, it will cause you to separate from some of those friends. And the reason being is, it's not because you're trying to separate from them. It's going to be them separating from you, because the scripture says, Joseph's brothers envied him. And that's one of the worst kind of sins you can have. Why is it? It's worse than jealousy, because when I looked up what jealousy was, jealousy happens when a person begins to covet what you have. Envy, on the other hand, it's a little bit worse, because it's when a person covets what you don't have.
Don't miss that.
There are so many people that know that God has a great plan for your life, and because of that, they want to do anything that they can do to stop you, to prohibit you, to limit you from realizing your maximum potential. Some of y'all think that people just don't like you. The reason is not that they just don't like you. They just don't like where God is going to take you. They don't like what God is going to do in your life. They don't like how you pray or not. They don't like how you give God praise. It might be somebody on your own road right now that's upset with you giving God some praise. They're saying, oh, she need to shut up. I want a good pastor. He need to sit down. He's moving too much. But can I say, you should never allow anybody to stop your praise. You should never allow anybody to stop your prayer, because many people don't know
I got to give him all that I have. Psalms 14 and 30 says this: a sound heart is life to the body, but envy is rottenness to the bones. Everybody won't celebrate your success. Everybody won't celebrate what God is doing in your life. Everybody won't be happy that you're excelling in the things of God, because they have some envy. They're scared of what God is going to do in your life. But they, all they have to do is turn to God and begin to concentrate on what God can do in their life. Because he's the God of all, and the very thing that he's doing in your life, he can begin to do in their life. Because the God that we serve is not a respected person. But envy is rottenness to the bones. Jacob tells Joseph to find his brothers that are out there caring for sheep. And he goes and he finds his brothers. And they saw him afar off. And the scripture says in verse 18, Joseph's brothers saw him coming from afar off. They decided to make a plan to kill him. They said to each other, here comes Joseph the dreamer. We should kill him now while we can. We could throw his body into one of those empty wells and tell our father that a wild animal killed him. Then we will show him that his dreams are useless. That leads me to my second thought. Beware of the dream killers. You got to beware of the dream killers. Amen. You don't know where they are. Some of them might be on your job. Some of them might come to your family reunion. You have to beware of the dream killers. Just because God is doing great things in your life, everybody won't be excited. And we have to begin to take the mindset that no matter who gets excited and no matter what the plot or the plan is, it's not going to separate me from attaining all that God has for my life.
That's right.
Some of them could be your boyfriend. Y'all not saying that. Some of them could be your girlfriend. Some of them might be your husband. Y'all not saying that. Some of them might be your wife. Your very children can be the ones assigned to stop you from realizing the dream that you have for your life. But you have to make sure that your affections and your attention is on God Almighty. And him only will I serve. Why? Because everything around me is subject to change. People come, people go. People are here for a reason. Some are here for a season. But the God that I serve is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Come what may, I'm going to live for Jesus and see that the dream that he has come forth from my life. Somebody touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, you can't stop it.
You can't stop it.
You can't stop it. There's people plotting, scheming, conspiring to stop the dream that you have on the inside of you. Hallelujah. I feel like making a declaration. Come on, let's stretch up this thing. Let's stretch up those hands. Hallelujah. Father God, I pray that every partner right here experience the dream that you have assigned to their life. We bind and abort every plot, every scheme, every tactic, every distraction, every hindrance that the enemy is trying to oppose upon their life. We declare, Lord God, that they have the victory, that they have the abundance, that they have the wealth, that every need shall be met, that they shall be made whole in every area of their life, and they shall have all that you want them to have in the name of Jesus. And we pray all these things in Jesus' marvelous name. Amen. Go ahead and put your hands together. That's your prayer. That's your petition. If you declare it, hallelujah.
established, so shall you be established.
Amen.
And the text says that they stripped him of his coat, the coat of many colors. They tried to strip him from the favor that Jacob bestowed upon his life. And the text says, they threw him in a pit. His brothers thought that they had him. They thought that they had gotten to him. But can I say, favor don't come from the outside in. It comes from the inside out. That's why the houses can come and go. The cars can come and go. People can come and go out of your life. But when you have the favor of God resting on your life, everything that you have ever lost, everything that have ever been left from out of your life, you can call it back for to come out of your life. Because the favor of God is not from the outside in. It works from the inside out. And his brothers thought that they were going to stop the dream that he had on his life. So they threw him in a pit. They threw him in a pit, thinking it was going to be the end. Somebody write this down. The pit prepares you for your purpose.
Yes, 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 yes.
This is good, this is good.
Yes.
Your pit, you might be in, some of y'all might be in the pit right now.
Yes.
What is that? A pit of bills right now.
Yes.
A pit of naysayers.
Yes.
A pit of unbelievers.
Yes.
They don't believe in the dream that God gave you.
Jesus.
They threw you in the pit. But the pit prepares you for the purpose that God has for your life. And I'm running out of time. And the scripture says that while you was in the pit, he was sold over into slavery. Potiphar's wife. He was sold into slavery. Potiphar bought him. But one of the great things about having favor in your life is that no matter where you find yourself at, you're going to always rise to the top. Somebody say, I'm the cream of the crop. I rise to the top. He found himself in Potiphar's house. Scripture says Potiphar's house became blessed. Not because of Potiphar, but because of Joseph. Some of y'all jobs, they goes open right now. Only because you work for them. And the scripture tells us that Potiphar's wife saw that Joseph was favored, saw that he was, get this, a man of excellence, saw that he was a man of distinction, saw that he was a man of class. And she longed for Joseph. And the scripture says that she conspired to sleep with him, but because Joseph walked in excellence and integrity, he would not be consumed by the enemy. How many of y'all know the favor that God has on your life will keep you from doing some things that sometimes you want to do? Y'all not saying, y'all not saying that. It is the goodness of God that leads us to repentance. Sometimes God will be so good to you where you might look at that boy and say, oh, looks good, but he ain't worth me losing what I got in Jesus. You look good, but not good enough to get me in that bed. Hallelujah. And that's what happened. She wanted Joseph that much to where she put her hands on Joseph, and Joseph ran out of that place, and the scripture says he left his clothes. Sometimes you have to run from that situation there. Man, I don't care how you got to get out those doors. Y'all have been in those situations. That just simply means that late at night when you with your sugar boo and your boo thing and your bae or whatever, and things get heated and you start taking things off because your body called. I don't even when doing something right. Ooh, I miss that. He did something right and still had to face the consequences. Illegally, he was in the jail. And while he was in the jail, he still rose to the top. They made him the head jail. Remember, the favor of God operates in any arena in life. If God called you to be a janitor, favor will make you the head janitor. If God called you to be a teacher, he'll make you the head teacher. If God called you on a job to work that job, he'll make you a supervisor and a manager and a general manager. And then when you get tired of working for them, God will find them and call you to be the boss. Because it causes you to rise up despite what you see, despite what you go through. Keep your dream alive. While he was in the jail, scripture says that the Pharaoh, he had a dream that he wanted interpreted. And the dream could not be interpreted by anybody else but Joseph. And he told the dream to Joseph. And Joseph said, I hear what that dream is. For 7 years, Egypt is going to experience lack. And for another 7 years, they're going to go into the glory side. And because he shared that with the king, Egypt was able to save grain for 7 years. And they did not have to suffer lack. All because of Joseph. This dream maker. This dreamer. I want to encourage you today to let you know your dream is bigger than just your life by itself. Some of y'all have some dreams that's going to affect Jacksonville. Some of y'all have some dreams that's going to affect the surrounding areas. Some of y'all have a national anointing on the inside of you. But the enemy wants to keep it stagnant. He wants to keep it contained. But the devil is a liar. You better keep the dream alive. You better get active on the praise team. You better get active on the dance field. You better get the preacher to God. But there's people assigned to the dream that's on your life. I even hear Dr. Martin Luther King that says, I have a dream that one day my children would not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream that one day all men will be, hallelujah, deemed to be created equal. But you gotta make this thing personal. I have a dream that one day Forward Christian Center, hallelujah, will impact the new North Side like never before. I have a dream, hallelujah, that one day every partner will experience the overflow that God has assigned to their life. I decree I have a dream that one day every partner shall live a life without stress, strain, or struggle. I have a dream, hallelujah, that every marriage shall be whole and attacked.